Hey there, welcome to AES tutorial. So AES stands for Advanced Encryption Standard. So it is used to specify a FIPS approved cryptographic algorithm that can be used to protect our electronic data. The FIPS number is 197. In this system we have message, the plain text, and we have secret key. A secret key is really secret. And combined, it will come as input. So the input and output for the AES algorithm consist of sequence of 128-bit digit with value 0 and 1. It will go to the cipher block. So this is a 128-bit message. It consists of secret key and plain text. It can be also of 192-bit. It can also go to 256-bit. No other bit is supported in AES design. So based on the bit information, what bit, either 128, 192 or 256, it will go to the cipher engine and it will produce a cipher text. So this cipher text should consist of 128-bit message if the input is 128, or it should produce 192-bit message if the input is 192-bit, or 256 if the input is 256-bit. So the cipher key for the AES algorithm is a sequence of 128, 192 and 256-bit. So as we can see, we have 128-bit keys, 192-bit and 256-bit messages. So 10, 12, 14 rounds for, so there are 10 round for 128 bits, 12 round for 192 bits and 14 round for 256 bit keys. Regular rounds are 9, 11 and 13. And final round is different from, 10, 12 and 14. Okay, so when the cipher message is processing, based on the bit, if this is a 128 bit, then there will one regular round of 9. The loop will be for 9. If this is 192-bit, the general loop will run for 11. If this is 256-bit, the loop will run for 13. And after coming out of the loop, the final round will be different. So final round will be 10th, 12th and 14th. So each round has certain processing involved in each round. So let's see what are those processing. So first processing is sub-bytes, the next processing shift rows, the third processing mixed column, and the fourth processing is add round key. So each round will consist of these four components: sub-bytes, shift rows, mixed columns and add round key. So it is advanced encryption standard 128-bit, the key length is 4. The block size is 4 and the number of round is 10. In 192-bit case, the number of round is 12 and the key length is 6. And in the case of 256-bit, the key length is 8 and the number round of 14. The block size is 4 in all 128, 192 and 256-bit pattern. So internally, the AES algorithm operation are performed on a 2D array of bytes. So we just see what is bytes, and that is called state. So this is a input byte sequence in a two-dimensional array where input byte will come. So this message will put into the cipher block and a cipher message will become. So entire process will occur on state machine. So output byte will be, so thus this is a state array. In this process, the entire algorithm will work and will get the final outcome of the message in output bytes. So this is the typical design of AES design flow, where we have plain text of 128-bit. We add a round key and we get a sub key, the first sub key out of it. Then we have 9 rounds. In this 9 rounds, we do byte, sub-byte, shift row and mixed column, and finally we add round key. एंड देन वी गेट द लास्ट सब की द 10th एंड फाइनली वी गेट द साइफर टेक्स्ट. दिस इज ओवरऑल डिजाइन ऑफ AES डिजाइन. सो लेट्स सी वन बाय वन व्हाट इज दिस. इज हेक्साडेसिमल रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ बिट पैटर्न्स. So this is the basic unit for processing in the AES algorithm. This is the hexadecimal diagram where we can see 0, the bit pattern is 0000. Similarly for 1, 0001, and for A it's 1010, and F is 1111, one byte. Okay, so using this formula, if you see what is the value of 0110011 is 63. So if you see the 6, it's 0110 0110, and 3 is 0011 0011, that becomes 63. The next thing is array of byte. So the array of byte will be represented using A0, A1, A2, and A15, 128 bit. The byte and bit ordering within the bytes are derived from the 128 bit input sequence, where input 0, 1, 2, 2, input 127. So this pattern will be extended for longer sequence for 192 bit, 252 bit keys. So that the, in general, the array of bytes will be presented as input of A10 plus 1 to A10 plus 7. So this is the AP, the arithmetic progression defined using array of byte in advanced encryption standard cipher algo. How does this look? As we can see, we have begin and end. And this is a for loop here. So first step, what we'll do, we'll add a round key in the state. So this is a 2D array, and based on the round, we'll perform the sub byte, shift rows, mix column, and add round key. So in the case of 128 bit, we'll loop till 9, and at the 10th round, the final round will be different. So in the final round, sub byte, shift rows, and add round key is happening. You can go back and see. Final round is different in 10, 12. So what is sub byte? So this is a transformation. So in this transformation, a non-linear byte substitution that operate independently on the each byte of the state using a S box. So in this case, the inverse of matrix is happening. Okay, in the sub byte step, each byte in this state is replaced with its in entry fix 8 bit lookup table SBIJ is equal to SIH. So A222 using S box replaced with B22. Second row and second column with second row and second column. So next, the shift row. In this transformation step, you can see the last three row of the states are cyclically shifted over the different number of bytes. So in this diagram, you can see like the first row is not getting changed, A0 0 0 1 0 2 and 0 3. This is remains same. We start shifting the rows so that this become A11, A1 become A12, A12 become A13, A13 become A10, the first shift. Similarly for this column, A20. So A20 become A22. So this shift happen. So in this case, the first row is not going to be changed. So this operate on the column level. And each column of the state is multiplied with the fixed polynomial function cx. The final round is add round key. So in this key, in this round key, a simple bitwise OR. So this is, you can see a bitwise OR operation is happening. So likewise, how we create cipher, we have to always look how to decipher it using inverse cipher mechanism, where we have inverse shift rows, inverse sub bytes, inverse mixed columns, and add round key. For more references, you can always refer to FIPS number 197 and wiki. Thanks for watching the video, and don't forget to subscribe to channel. Thank you very much.